Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Learn in Minutes, and today's topic is resective osseous surgery. I will be covering up this topic under the following outline, that is definition, rationale, indications, steps involved, instruments used, and conclusion. Osseous surgery is defined as a procedure by which changes in the alveolar bone can be accomplished to rid it of deformities induced either by periodontal disease or related factors. It could be of two types: additive procedures directed at restoring the alveolar bone to its original level, whereas subtractive or resective procedures that restore the form of the pre-existing alveolar bone to a level present at the time of surgery or slightly more apical to it. So basically, the rationale of resective osseous surgical procedures is to establish a physiologic contour that will not only facilitate good oral hygiene but also long-term maintenance. The various indications for resective osseous surgery include one-wall angular defects, wide shallow two-wall defects. Apart from this, it could also be done in interdental craters, early to moderate bone loss about 2 to 3 millimeters in teeth with moderate length root trunks, also used to expose fractured roots of abutments for easy removal. Apart from this, resective osseous surgery could also be done in the treatment of bony ledges, exostosis, ridge deformities, exposure of caries for restoration, etc. So the steps involved in resective osseous surgery are categorized into four. The first step is vertical grooving, next radicular blending, third, interproximal bone flattening, and finally, gradualizing of the marginal bone. The first two steps, that is the vertical grooving and the radicular blending, are basically osteoplasty procedures that involve reshaping of the bone without the removal of any of the tooth supporting bone. The next two steps, that is the flattening of interproximal bone and gradualizing marginal bone, are osteotomy procedures that involve the removal of tooth supporting bone. Let's see what are the various instruments used. We can use a range of instruments for resective osseous surgery that include bone rongers, chisels such as the back action or the ocean bean chisels, interproximal files such as the Schlugger and the Sugarman files, burrs such as carbide and diamond burrs. So to conclude with, we can say that resective osseous surgery is definitely effective in reducing pocket depth, but is associated with loss of attachment as well as gingival recession being its main disadvantage. So that's all for now guys. If you've liked my videos, please subscribe to my channel and hit the like button. Thank you.